Hey guys, I'm Ryan Wright.
And I'm Alicia Sixtus.
Yes, she is. Okay, so we're going to check out the trailer for Stonewall. This stars Jeremy Irving, oh, I forgot how to say his last name, and Jonathan Rhys Meyers. Oh, he's beautiful.
Yeah.
John, do you know who he is?
No.
You don't know who he is? Okay. No. Way to play along. Yes, and improv. Sexual content, language throughout, some violence, and drug use.
Okay.
Our nation was founded on a bedrock principle. That we are all created equal. Seneca Falls, Selma, and Stonewall. Ordinary people can do extraordinary things.
Gay is good.
I'm gonna get you all figured out. Grew up in Kansas. And mama probably baked apple pies. Yo, everybody, this is Danny. Welcome to New York.
I could be that guy's best friend, I feel it.
Don't use your real name. It was run by the mob.
Ron Perlman?
We're an organization that fights for gay rights.
What are you looking at, faggot?
Ouch.
Up against the wall.
This is what we're fighting.
Oh, what, him?
In a peaceful way. And resist the radicalism that I see starting to take hold.
I have not seen one dream come true on Christopher Street, baby.
There is no hope. There is no family, Danny.
I like being mad.
These kids have nothing left to lose.
I can't love you.
That's not the way, Danny. It's the only way.
Someone always breaks the window in these
days. They're having a parade to commemorate the fighting commitment called Gay Liberation March.
I'm coming.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
I am proud of gay people. That's how I feel.
That is so awesome. I'm so happy that they made this.
You know what looks really cool about it? You know, we've seen movies about like gay rights and all that, but to see a film where they're making like gay, at least in the trailer, they're making gay people look like hardcore manly badasses.
Yes.
As opposed to, oh, they were just going to make them, you know,
exactly.
Typical gay
characters. They made them the heroes.
They made them the badass heroes, the ones who are tough. And that's cool to see that, because normally a gay character gets put in some type of typecast position, but these are like rebels.
Yeah.
So it's pretty cool to see that.
No, this is amazing. I think that this film is going to do really well. And it's going to do good for people's, like, you know, their opinions, you know?
We're hoping to change opinions.
Right.
That's what Alicia's hoping
for. I am. I am.
She's the biggest activist for them.
Come on.
The production value looks really good too, actually. It does have have you seen Milk?
Yes, of course.
It does have that kind of vibe, but a little darker, a little bit tougher.
More of the fight.
Yeah, seems like Selma inspired in a lot of ways. Mm. I think they even mentioned Selma at the beginning of this. My concern when I saw this person's name come up was from director Roland Emmerich, who did films like Independence Day, and then he's done a lot of shitty films, like the 90s Godzilla film, The Day After Tomorrow, 2012. He usually does these like big disaster films.
Uh-huh.
This looks like well made. It looks a little cliche though. I kind of feel about stories like this that I don't care if they're cliche as long as if it's still done well, a cliche can be okay, you know?
Yeah.
Cliche can be okay. Rapping. Skills. I hope this movie is executed well because it could be one of those powerful films. You know, like, I remember when Brokeback Mountain came out.
Right.
That was a huge fucking deal when that movie came out. There was some type of influence that film played into Community,
mm-hmm.
you know, and this film could do something similar. I mean, gay rights, it's like gay people can get married in all 50 states now, but there's other countries where people still hate gay people, you know, like it's not everywhere in the world where it's accepted. And, I know what that's like. I know what that's like. I tried being gay for like a day. Like a month.
Really?
didn't work
out. I mean, we've all done that.
Got some horrible Craigslist stories.
Oh, God.
Yeah, can't talk about that right now. The guy with the long hair, who's like the one introducing this Danny character into the world, mm-hmm. I think I could be like good friends with him in real life.
Well, you should find him on Facebook,
then. I should find him on Facebook, but I don't want him to get the wrong impression. Like, what if he's gay in real life? No. I don't want him to think I'm coming on to him.
No, just a fan that wants to hang out.
Yeah, exactly. Like, I don't want him to think I'm coming on to him, but I would like him to come on to me.
Right.
That way I feel better about my ego.
Right. I mean, that's how we all wish that we could, you know, get a date, but it doesn't work like that. Sometimes you gotta bite the bullet and go for it.
I'm not trying to get a date. I just want him to find me attractive.
Right.
For my own personal satisfaction.
Okay, so you didn't want to... Okay.
Yeah, I have no interest in dating this guy.
Okay, that's okay.
But I mean,
it's okay if you did.
I'm like that with all gay people.
Oh, okay.
I just want all gay people to find me attractive, but I want
So you're like the kind of guy who goes to the gay club just so you can get like...
Yeah, I like to boost my self-esteem, you know? Throwing a brick through a window. That's a common thing in all... biographical pictures or whatever, true stories. It's either a shot glass against the wall, like a glass of alcohol that they had at like 12 o'clock in the afternoon, or it's a brick through a window.
Yes.
You know, that shows chaos and power.
Yeah, and when it's got writing on it, that makes it even more intense.
Oh yeah, there's probably going to be some.
Like, there's always like a message attached to it.
When I started dating your sister, that's how I got her attention.
You threw a brick
through many bricks through the window.
I remember that.
Bricks. Your dad did not like me.
No.
For a solid 2 years.
No, I don't think we liked you.
I'm pretty sure none of Veronica didn't even like me.
I'm just kidding.
That's okay.
He's been around forever.
Like 10 years.
10 years I've known this
10
guy.
Plus. 10 plus. 10 plus.
Well, since he was a little kid. Now he's a big kid.
Yeah.
Now he's a big kid who just, like, tells dirty jokes.
Hey, I've been good today. I'd watch myself.
He's been really good. Not even, like, in, like, real life.
I'm trying to pull out actual wit. You know how hard that is?
Yeah, actually, that's like...
Sex jokes are way easier.
I know how hard that is because you...
Ah, she said,
like,
I can't do that.
What?
Anyway, guys, thanks for tuning into the channel. If you're new to it, you can subscribe to The Real Rejects.
Yeah.
You can catch Alicia on East Los High and The Fosters. And don't forget to vote for her. There's a link in the description box.
Yes.
Vote for her so she can feel better about herself.
I mean, you can vote for me. If you like me, vote for me. If you don't, then you don't have to.
When someone's promoting you, you don't have to worry about the self-promotion part. Okay.
I mean, I'm just saying, if you don't want to vote, it's okay. We're not putting a gun to your head. But if you do want to vote,
keep
like,
going.
Hey, I mean, if you like,
you're
whatever.
Still going. All right. And you could also follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Her Instagram has more followers than me. It's pissing me off. I need to surpass her. So follow me on Instagram.
No, but follow me, Alicia Sixtos. Just search me and then you'll find me.
You're really Instagram-y though. You really like Instagram.
I like Instagram. That's the only one that I really focus on. I'm starting to get into Snapchat a little bit. Ali Be Cool. K-O-O. Ali. A-L-I.
That's you.
B-E-K-O-O. Ali Be Cool.
Yeah,
on Snapchat.
You made it easy for people to find you.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Find me. I snap every once in a while.